Okay, hello everyone. So in this clip we are going to see about a Fourier series. What is Fourier series and why do we need Fourier series? So before going to the Fourier series, let's say something about the Taylor series. That is the topic which we learn before Fourier series. So what Taylor did was, he said that if you have a nice function means if you have a function f which is a continuous, I mean not even continuous, but if you have a function which is differentiable everywhere on some interval, and if it has the derivatives of all order, means f, its derivative, double derivative, all the derivative exist, then you can write your function as some polynomial of order n plus the remainder term. That means you can approximate your function with a polynomial. This will call as error. And if this remainder term goes to zero, then your function is nothing but this power series. And this coefficient can be written as the nth derivative of f at point a upon n factorial. That's what he said. So what Taylor did is, he said two important things. He said that you can approximate your function with a polynomial of any order you want depending upon the error. And secondly, if something nice happens, then your function is nothing but a power series centered at a, where a is some interior point of the interval. So these are the two basic things what Taylor said. Now let's come to Fourier. What Fourier did? So Fourier asked the question that, can you express a function as a combination of a wave functions? That means, why wave functions? No, okay. So first of all, why wave functions? See, like whenever a signal is passed, or even when I am talking right now, whenever these informations are passed, this information are passed in the form of a wave. So wave comes across everywhere. So when Fourier was doing some work, he asked the question that, can I express my function as a combination of a wave functions? And the basic waves which we know is the sine and the cosine waves. So he asked that, can I write my function as some a naught plus a1 cos x plus a2 cos 2x plus a3 cos 3x. That means all cosine terms plus b1 sine x plus b2 sine 2x plus b3 sine 3x and so on. So he asked this question that, can I write my function as a combination of the basic cos and sine functions? And the answer came out to be yes. He proved that yes, if you have a good function. See, Taylor asked much more thing. He said that a function has the derivatives of all order, which is not the case in this case. So what Fourier said, even if you have a piecewise continuous and a periodic function, still you can do these nice things. So I will come to it, I mean, regarding the periodicity and the piecewise continuous function, maybe in the next 2-3 clips. But yeah, that's what ultimately the Fourier proved. He said that you can write your function as a naught plus summation n runs from 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus bn sine nx, if the function is a periodic function over an interval minus pi to pi. I mean, all these details I will go through it, but this is just an introduction, so that's why I'm not going into much detail. So this is what the Fourier asked, and that's what he proved later on as well. Now if you observe one thing, there is a naught term, but there is no b naught term, because when my n is 0, my sine 0 is 0, therefore b naught term will not come to the picture, whereas when my n is 0, cos 0 is 1, therefore a naught term will come into the picture. So that's what the Fourier did. Okay so before taking an example, let's see the definition of a periodic function. So what do you mean by periodic function? So periodic functions are nothing but those function which will keep on repeating the same values after certain interval. So the very basic periodic functions are sine x and cos x. So you know that the graph of sine x is nothing but from 0 to 2 pi it is like this, and from 2 pi onwards it will keep on taking the same value. Here also it will keep on taking the same value. So therefore, if I know the value of the function over this interval, I know the value over all the points of the real number. So that's why periodic functions are good functions. No need to study over the whole real line, only study them over the specific intervals and you know the whole nature of the function. So sine is a periodic function, and this, since after 2 pi interval it's keep on repeating, therefore this 2 pi is called as the period of the function. So in general, if f of x is a periodic function of period 2 pi, that means what? Value of the function is same as after the period 2 pi. That means function takes the same value after the period 2 pi. In general, if p is the period, then f of x is same as f of x plus p. In that case, p is called as the period of the function. The second basic example is the cosine of x. So what is cos x? It's again the same thing. From 0 to 2 pi, it is like this. And again from 2 pi onwards, it will keep on repeating. So cos x is also an example of a sine function. It's also an example of a periodic function whose period is 2 pi. So that's about periodic function. One more example if you want to see, sine 2x. Now sine x had a period 2 pi, therefore sine 2x will have the period pi, because as soon as I will come towards pi, since it is 2 pi, so when x is pi by 2, sine 2 pi by 2 will be nothing but sine pi. So at pi by 2, it will come out to be 0. So 0 to pi. So it will get compressed. So therefore, after pi interval, it will keep on repeating. In general, if I have sine kx, then sine kx will have period pi by k. Actually, it is pi, but actually it is nothing but 2 pi by 2. So sine 2x will have period 2 pi by 2, sine 3x will have period 3 pi by 2 pi by 3, sine kx will have period 2 pi by k. Similarly for cos x. So all these functions are periodic functions, and therefore the Fourier series which we wrote, f of x as summation an cos nx plus bn sin nx, all those cos nx and sin nx are the periodic functions. Okay, now let me tell you an example which will help you to understand this concept. So if you take this example, which is a square wave, so what does this mean? We have a function from minus pi to pi, where it is taking the value half from the interval 0 to pi and taking the value minus half from the interval minus pi to 0. So as you can see, it is a discontinuous at 0, so it is not even differentiable function, and it's a periodic, means after the interval from minus pi to pi, it is keeping on taking the same value, therefore it's a periodic function. Now I know that what is sine x? Sine x is nothing but this wave. So from 0 to pi, it is this wave, minus pi to pi, it is this wave, this is half and minus half, and this is my sine wave function. As you can see, sine and this square wave, there are no way near to each other. But if I add this term to sine x, means sine 3x by 3, if you observe, when I add them, this becomes much more closer to the square wave. That means this is a good approximation as compared to sine x. What if I add one more term to it? What I want to say is, suppose if I erase this part, and suppose now if I consider this curve, sine x plus sine 3x by 3 plus sine 5x by 5, then question is how this curve will look like. Answer to this is, it will go like this, 1, 2, 3. And then again, it's not a good drawing, but what I want to say is, it will become like this. If you have a software, then you can just add these three terms. And this is how this curve will look like. And as you can see, as compared to the previous two cases, this sum is much more closer to our square wave function. In general, if I add infinitely many terms, as the things will roll over, it will be final, ultimately will be this many waves here, and here it will be this many waves. And again, if this was my pi, again this will come down continuously, and again this many waves, again it will come up, again this many waves, here it will come up, this many waves. So as you can see, what we did is, we approximate our wave function with the help of this sine wave function, and you can see it's a continuous, and plus they are approximated with the help of a wave. So that's what the Fourier did. He approximated this bad function, the square wave function. Not bad, but yeah, bad in the sense it was discontinuous. There were sharp edges, there were sharp points. So it's a discontinuous function with the sharp points. But because of the Fourier series, what we got was we got this lines, we approximated with the curves, plus we removed the discontinuity, and therefore this is approximated with the smooth curves. So that's why Fourier is very much important. It helps us to approximate the function with the waves, moreover with the continuous waves. So now, how to find this series and what are the other things behind the Fourier funda, that we'll discuss in the coming lectures. Have a nice day.